And Shout, Shout, Let It All Out was the anthem that shot to number one in 1985. It then became the ditty everyone loved to hate. Tears for Fears, who penned the offending lyrics, seemed to disappear from the face of the earth after their short stay at the pinnacle. But 4 years on from Songs from the Big Chair, they're back with a new album and a catchy single that has everyone delving back into their Beatles collection. Curt Smith has words on the new work from Tears for Fears.
After two hugely successful albums, The Hurtin' and Songs from the Big Chair, you'd have thought that Tears for Fears would stick to their original commercial formula on their latest album, The Seeds of Love, but they haven't.
After the last tour, I did say I'd never want to do that again. I just don't want to go through that. And this time around, I've been in a studio for 2.5 years nearly, and I want to get out and play again because it's, you know, we are musicians, and it's great fun for those 2 hours a night playing on stage. It's the travelling and everything else that gets to be a pain. But if all that's well arranged, and we've arranged it well in advance this time, then I think it will be okay. I mean, I'm sure by the end of the 6 month period, I'll be saying I never want to do that again. But, you know, I'm quite looking forward to it as it is.
So out went the angst, out went the arty young wince with synthesizers, and in came live musicians and singers. One such singer is Aletta Adams. After a concert in Kansas on their last tour, the boys went to relax at the bar. Playing the piano and singing was this woman with an extraordinary voice. And when Curt and Roland returned to London, they decided Aletta had what they wanted, and they went in search of her.
So we flew back to Kansas, and she was playing in a different hotel, and we spent a few days there, got to know her, and she was such a great person, and she was still as good as we remembered her to be. So we brought her back to England, and she sings and plays piano on the album, and is now going to come out and tour with us, more the fool her.
As a prequel to the new album, a single, Sowing the Seeds of Love, has been released. Because it has a decidedly Beatles psychedelic feel, they decided to approach Jim Blatchill to make the video.
It's really weird for us because it's the first time we've given something to someone and had no real control over it, because all we did is we went out there for 2 days and he shot us doing our bits in front of a blue background and made us, you know, do all these certain movements. And he said, don't worry, there's going to be an animated such and such in there, so don't feel a fool. It's very hard not to feel a fool doing that kind of stuff. So it was a bit weird when we were doing it, but I've seen clips of it now, and it was quite nerve-wracking because you've let someone else do it and we don't really have any control over it. And it comes in, you know, a few days before the single goes out, so if it wasn't very good, we'd have to use it anyway. But I saw some clips of it and it's great. I mean, he's done such a good job.
So Tears for Fears have really moved on. The angst is gone. The teenage music to commit suicide by is also out. But what happened to the arty young wimps with synthesizers?
We're more sort of arty old wimps with guitars now, really.